my name is Lê Quang Đức.
I am Nguyễn Đức Bảo Lâm.
We are from Information Technology Club from Nông Đa School, Đà Lạt, Việt Nam. And today we are here to present to you about our project, Warning System for the Forest Protection.
We choose this project because of some reasons.
Firstly, there are many wildfires around the world. Wildfires could be caused by global warming or climate change. Secondly, people want to steal land for cultivation and they burn a lot of trees. And besides, loggers cut down many trees for stealing wood and doing the illegal delivery to get black money. And this situation is too hard for a rancher to solve because a small group of rancher is impossible to manage all the forests. So we choose project. We want to save the forest. We want to detect the dangerous situation as soon as possible to solve those problems. We will show you about our system.
Our warning system consists of 3 devices informing blue tree paths. The first one is forest devices, the second one is intermediate transmitter, and the last one is center processor in office.
With the forest device, it contains a ESP32 camera, a voice recognition V3, the DHT11, and the air quality sensor MV135. And the main board is MicroBit V2 and V1 to receive data and send data. And a LoRa sensor to send data. In the intermediate transmitter, it contains a MicroBit and the LoRa sensor to receive data and transmit to another station. And the last one is the post, it is the office. It contains ESP8266 to send data to the server. Let's see how the system works. At first, ESP32 camera will capture image and send to the server after 500 milliseconds. And after that, if in case there's fire, server will post image to Facebook, Gmail, and user to warn users. And you see, lamp, he is burning the fire. And ESP32 camera has captured the image. And the voice recognition V3 will record the sound. And if there's the same sound as trend sound, the voice recognition V3 will send signal to MicroBit. And now LUM will make the chainsaw sound. And if there's no danger, the DHT11 will send temperature and humidity data to the MicroBit, and after that MicroBit will send the data to LoRa. And LoRa is a network that we can transmit the data through a longer distance. And we experiment that the max distance is 3 kilometers, but we can use another sensor to transmit with a longer distance.
Getting data from intermediate transmitter, the center processor in office in the last station at Hewick divided into 2 groups of data, the set data and the dangerous data. Each day in the set one, temperature and humidity will be sent to Heroku server as a line diagram. The purpose is to evaluate easier. If they are dangerous one, image in Python will be sent to Facebook, Gmail, and website to Heroku server. And there is a track message.
And as we can see, why we test with the device, it is my cameraman and the device detects him.
And about a special mode for recognizing working condition. If the center device could not get data from the forest device, message will be passed to Facebook to warn the rangers.
Compared with the first version, our system is now working better. And in the future, we will build the GPS system to help the ranger know exactly where danger happens. And that's all for our project.
Thanks for watching.